Do you want to be focused more so that you can get more of your stuff done and become a productivity beast? What's going on, guys? This is Robin Williams. Welcome to this video. In this video, I'm just going to share with you some of the tools that I love to use. And my disclaimer to you guys is don't get caught up on these apps. Don't be caught up on too many tools, because eventually they become, a issue. They become a thing that's in the way. So I'm going to get into the first thing that I really love to use, and I'll give you some tips on how I use it. Maybe it'll work for you the same, maybe it won't, but here goes. The first app is ToDo for Google. I really, really love this app. As you can see, I'm already building out a checklist for my email marketing strategy. And I'm building this out because I like to establish a checklist to check it off. Tick, tick, tick. Gives me dopamine, right? Probably gives you dopamine too. Some people like writing things down on a piece of paper to get these things done, or scratching it off with a pencil. So if that's you, you might want to use something else so you can print it off and then basically scratch it off. But I like ToDo for Google because it's very simplistic. It syncs with my computer and my phone, meaning what I see here is what I see on my phone. Okay. I can use my phone and pretty much chop off at the checklist if I want, but most of my stuff is done at the computer. Okay. So I use this to establish a list. Basically, I have a daily routine, Facebook marketing, YouTube marketing. Now I'm having my email marketing strategy on a list. I have a couple other miscellaneous stuff on here, but this is one of my favorite apps for a checklist. Okay. So basically it just helps me check things off. Okay. Real simple. This ToDo for Google. I'll show you where to go to get this at the end of this video. And I actually have a video on it. So hopefully I don't have a video on this. Sorry, wrong app. Okay, the next app is the one I actually have a video on. It is called Checker Plus for Google Calendar. I really like this. It syncs up with your Google Calendar, and to me, it's just super quick when it comes to putting things on your calendar. Okay, so what that means is that if I'm sitting here, working, as I do a lot, if I'm sitting here working, I could literally go to my calendar and just put things on my calendar. Also, when I'm sitting here and if I have an appointment that comes up, it pops up for me on my calendar. What is today's date? Let's see if I could put a little test on here for you. And then let's try this again. I'm going to put my website on here. Oops, I clicked on the wrong thing. All right, let's just say I do a test. And then it's not all day. Let's just say it is, what time is it? 10:40. So let's say it's 10:42. Okay. And where I usually put, if it's a link or a Zoom, I usually put it there because it's clickable, right? And so I'm just going to save this, and we should see a pop-up come here shortly. Okay. So I really like this because it just takes the pain out of trying to find Google Calendar link and open it up a new tab just to go to your calendar, or stopping what you're doing on your phone, on your computer, and going to your phone. And I'm not a great phone typer. So, that kind of sucks. As you can see, it's telling me I have something coming up in 1 minute. Okay. That's what I put on the calendar. All right. So that's my second favorite tool. I don't put a lot on there because, to be honest, guys, the tool that I just showed you prior to that, that's kind of my calendar. I don't put it in hard stone on when to do it. I just know this is the crap I got to do every day if I want to have success in my business. So I get up and I have to do it and check it off. All right. As you can see, it pops up. You can snooze it if you want, and you can click on it to go to the site, right? Pretty cool. All right. And then, if you don't check it off, it'll be there later. I think it's somewhere behind this window, but basically you can check it off and it'll be done. Okay. This next one I have been using to really put in focus. I honestly just started using this, and the next thing that I'll show you as a bonus. But I just started using this and I really liked it. It's basically almost like a, you know, if you ever did those Tabata workouts where you do a workout for however many minutes and you stop for however many minutes or whatever, it's almost like that. You get focus and everything. You get focus time and then you get break times. So basically, I don't think it's called Focus to Do. It is called, what are you called? Pomodoro timer. Okay. Pomodoro Doro timer. Don't talk about my pronunciation, y'all. All right. So what this app does, what I'm about to use it for is I'm about to sit here and work on my membership bonus site till I finish. I'm dreading getting this done. I used it for the first time writing my emails. And I was like, oh my gosh, like I ran into a couple of hiccups. Instead of doing 4 sessions, I did like 9 sessions, right? And so you just add however many sessions you want. So each session is 25 minutes. You might be able to change the settings on here. I just went with the regular settings, right? And then once you play it, I'm gonna go ahead and play this. It counts down. You get to work, whatever. Do whatever it is that you're doing. Focus on whatever it is that you're doing. When a timer goes off, boom, you get a 5-minute break. Okay. So I usually use that 5-minute break. And then I think every 2 or 3 breaks, you get like a 15-minute break on here. Not gonna lie, guys, I take like between 15 and 30 minutes, depending on what I feel like. If I feel like a nap, I take a nap, put a timer on, come back, get to work, okay? Play with my dog, whatever it is. I really like this app because it allows you to focus. I will tell you this, when you hit that wall, when you're like, oh my gosh, you're like on this third one and you're tired for whatever reason, maybe you got the itis from eating so much or something. So you're gonna hit that wall, you take a little break, you get back to it, and basically you'll probably get a second win. I hope you do, you know. And then when you get that second win, you just keep going until that task, that project is finished. Probably do the hardest thing. I almost skipped over this today, right? But I said, you know what? I need to get this done, and it is what it is, right? The next thing is for readers. If you're a reader, you're really gonna love this. You're really gonna love this. All right, so let me take you to I don't even know if it's called an app. I don't even know what it is, but it's this thing called Bookcision. Okay, I'll have the link in this video because you probably can't see the link up here, but basically it's a book called it's a app software whatever called Bookcision. They teach you how to download it. I think you just drag this up there and follow a couple steps, right? And what I like is that if you like to read on the like your books, physical books, I encourage you to try this way of reading on Kindle. I mean, the guy that introduced me to it, I was like, if you know, F this is not how I do things. I like to fill the pages, I like to highlight, right? I was like, I ain't gonna like it, but I'm gonna try to be coachable, right? So I literally love this thing. So if you go to Kindle, your settings, first of all, won't look like this. What happened was I really wasn't feeling it. I was like, oh, I knew I wasn't feeling it. You know, I don't like to read from the computer. And so what happened was I started looking at the settings. Okay, so you once you go to this read.amazon.com for your books, you could literally change your settings, right? You can do 2 pages, 1 page, whatever. So I played with it, the colors, the font size. You know, I got this big old font up here, as you can see, and then you know, you can click and go to the next page, you know, and it's honestly pretty cool. And what Bookcision does is once you decide that you have something that you like, you go and highlight it, and it creates your notes so that you can go read it later. It creates it on your Kindle notes right here so that you can read these bad boys later, okay? Or copy and paste them somewhere else. So that's pretty cool. You can just gather your notes. You put on some meditation music with this bad boy real low and read. I'm telling you, your focus will be on point. So instead of dismissing this, try it. All right, so this is the real Robin Williams. What I do is I kind of help people get their business off the ground. I kind of help them to use things like YouTube and Facebook to get their business, you know, to a great start. If that's something that's that interests you, definitely check out the link below. What I'll have there is the all-in-one link. Yeah, I'll have the all-in-one link for you. And basically, this explains to you everything that comes with it. But ultimately, guys, if you're trying to market your business online, you want to read through this. You want to, you know, this is probably geared more towards affiliates. But I give you this link anyway because you get the most bonuses. But inside of this system, you'll get the best marketing training on earth when it comes to free marketing strategies for small businesses. This is Robin Williams. I see you on the top. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.